All right, kia ora, happy Monday to all of you. We're going to get into Dataverse MCP and Copilot Studio. So last week I showed you how to do this on your desktop, how to create a Dataverse MCP server on your desktop and do some really cool stuff with Cloud Desktop and VS Code with Dataverse. This week we're going to get into how to do this in Copilot Studio. And this is really the business end of it, because now we can start to see MCP and Dataverse doing some stuff that our clients would ask us to do when we're creating agents for them. So what we're going to get through this evening is I'm going to show you how to configure this in Copilot Studio. It is super easy to do. It literally takes 20 seconds. We'll then go through how to create a record, how to update a record, so you can start to get an idea of what this can do. And then we'll touch on the business value of this. Now, I do have a much cooler demo that I am planning, I'm hoping to share with you in the coming days, about halfway through getting it to work. But in the meantime, I'll just give you a simple example of how this works in Copilot Studio so you can start to see what it's capable of. All right, so let's pop out of this and head into Copilot Studio. So I've got an agent here called Dataverse MCP Demo, and it's got some very basic instructions. These are courtesy of Julie Cosmarno at Microsoft. Thank you, Julie. Julie's leading development of this particular part of Copilot Studio. So what this agent does is it just lets me chat with my data and create and update records in Dataverse. And the way I do that is with MCP Server. So I'm going to come over here to Tools, and I've added this Dataverse MCP Server. And in order to do that, super easy to do, just click on Add a Tool. And if you've worked with agents in the past, then you know this is where you come to get them to do stuff. They've had actions that's been renamed to tools. This is where you could add cloud flows. And the new kid on the block is Model Context Protocol right here. And so when I click on this, I see I've got a bunch of options to let it start interacting using MCP. And in this case, we want to use the Dataverse MCP server. Now, a quick note, So what you need to do to add it is just click on this and click Add to Agent. It's going to pop up something saying, how do you want to authenticate? It's going to default to OAuth. Just say yes, and it will work for you. Now, you don't actually need to do any config of this, which is really cool. So you simply add it. This is all I did on Friday. I've added this in. I've got my tools that it can do. You might remember this from the demo last week: listing, describing, tables, querying, creating and updating, all that cool stuff. So it's all there for you. That's it. It's literally 20 seconds. Add it and you're done. Okay. Now, a quick note that I want to call out before we continue is you've got to do this within the context of an agent. When you come to Copilot Studio, and before going into the context of an agent, so we've got our agents here, but if I just click on Tools, you can see I've got my connectors, and I do have the option to add a tool. If I do that, we do see MCP, but when you click on that, it's just going to bounce you out to the Microsoft doc, so it doesn't let you do anything. So make sure you're in the context of an agent. All right, I think we are ready to give this a test. So I'm going to give this a quick refresh. And we'll cross our fingers and toes to the demo gods. And so let's just say, create a product row called Awesome YouTube Demo. Now it's going to go away. It's going to talk to MCP Server. And it's going through and creating this table for me. It's going to let me know when it's done. And it's done that here. Now, I've asked it to provide me with a clickable URL. That's not working at the moment. But if I come over here to my model-driven app and I refresh, you can see that we've just created a row. Product row called Awesome YouTube Demo. And I did that just with natural language. All I did was add MCP server and talk to my agent, and I'm already creating data. All right, let's say I want to update it. I've got this column here called product comment. This is null. Let's update it. So let's come back here to my agent, and I'm going to say update the product comment column on the product you just created with pretty cool demo. Again, this is going to call MCP Server. It's going to go and do its thing to update this row, and it should let us know when it's done. All right, it's let us know that it's finished, so let's come back here. And when I refresh this row, I expect to see that value here in product comment. So let's go ahead and do a quick refresh. And look at that, it did it. Super, super cool. All from natural language, I am creating and updating rows in Dataverse from an agent. All right, now it's a fairly simple demo, but let's segue to the business value of this. What does this mean for you as you are creating agents for your clients? Why do you care about this? Well, in the past, prior to MCP, when we wanted to interact with things like Dataverse, we had to go and create actions, now called tools, or cloud flows to do this. So I'm going to come over here to another Copilot agent that I created. This is one that I created earlier this year to take WhatsApp messages and interpret them and do stuff with them in Dataverse. And you can see that I've got three separate actions here based on what I need to happen. Find the contact, update the contact, send an in-app notification. These are all things that I need my agent to do, and I had to create three separate actions, and I had to go in and give it all this context. So I had to write all these descriptions in each of these actions. Whereas with MCP, when I come over here, all I had to do was connect to it. I created a connection to it, and then in my agent, I just gave it some instructions. And so we are getting closer and closer to natural language letting us do stuff in Dataverse, which is really, really exciting. So it's less and less config and more just type out what you want the agent to do, and it's starting to do stuff. And so that's where we're starting to get to this business value. It lets us create more stuff faster in Copilot Studio. So I hope this was helpful. I hope this helps you understand what you can do with MCP Server in Dataverse and why this is a really cool development. Reach out to me if you have any questions or anything that doesn't make sense. In the meantime, go do something awesome on the Power Platform today, and I'll talk to you all soon.